The New York Football Giants are next up on the docket. Their win total this year sits at 7. To go over is minus 135. To go under is plus 105. So, of course, Vegas seems to think, for whatever reason, that going under is less likely than going over. They got the third best odds in the division at plus 400 to win the NFC overall, plus 2,800. And to make the playoffs, they are plus 200. To not make it is minus 260. Season win total has gone under 8 of the last 11 years and 7 of the last 8. In 2020, they went under the 6.5, but only by half a game. Opponent win strength or win percentage schedule strength is number 25, and they are projected favorites in 5 games. Now, Saquon Barkley comes back. Can he stay healthy? That has been the question thus far in his career. The offense had the second lowest points averaged per game last season, only averaged 17.5 per game. Wide receiver core this year? Upgraded significantly. You got Kenny Galladay, John Ross, first rounder, Kadarius Toney out of Florida. The question is, can Daniel Jones find those guys along with Evan Ingram? He's kind of had some issues with that. The offensive line didn't seem like it was fixed a whole lot in the offseason, and they were pretty bad last year. The defense generated the fourth most fumbles last year, but they only recovered 39% of them. That was number 26 in the league. And they're going to have to get turnovers. Like, they are just going to have to be able to create those. Hopefully they'll have better turnover luck this year. They were not able to get pressure last year on defense, but they did draft outside linebacker Azeez Ojulari. I have got the Giants going under again, and it has everything to do with Jason Garrett. I think he's insanely predictable. I don't know that Daniel Jones is a good quarterback. Even with all these weapons, I don't know that he'll be able to actually get the ball to them. What are your thoughts here?
Yeah, I'm the same way. I've got him 6-11. So that's under. I don't think they're going to be great. I don't like teams where your best player on the football team is your running back. I just don't think that that brings you enough value to equate wins. And it's a running back coming off an injury. I mean, yes, for some reason he's hobbled at any chance, which I don't think he is. We live in a world now where ACLs get repaired so easily. These guys, you know, all, I don't know that the last time we had somebody tear one and then not come back. So I'm not too concerned about that. It's just the ability to, what good is that? I think Daniel Jones is a lot better than you give him credit for. But the problem is I don't trust them. You're right, Jason Garrett, to be able to scheme up anything special. And I don't think this defense is very good. And, you know, I don't trust them. I've listened to a lot of NFL people, and I've read a lot of NFL stuff over the last 2 months. And there's a lot of folks that are high on this team. And I just can't see it, man.
Well, they caught on, you know, kind of caught on fire a little bit towards the end of the season. But
look at the teams they played at the end of that season.
Exactly, though. Exactly. That's why I'm questioning it.
Issue is we always say, oh, this team finished strong and they beat yada 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 and they did this and that, and then we don't look at who they actually beat to do those things.
Yeah, yeah, I'm with you. So we are both going under on the Giants. Thanks for listening to the Winning Cures Everything podcast. The website is winningcureseverything.com, and if you want to connect with us, we're on Twitter at GaryWCE, at ChrisBGiannini, at Winning Cures, or you can email us, Gary@winningcureseverything.com or Chris@winningcureseverything.com. Subscribe everywhere you need to subscribe, and we'll see you soon.